Hi, welcome to another episode of Ichimoku Cloud Analysis. Today I'm going to analyze Bitcoin to see if there is a better buying opportunity coming up in the future, or this is it, Bitcoin has bottomed out and we should just buy right now. My name is Kiana Danial. I'm the founder of the Invest Diva movement. I'm also the author of a bunch of books that you can see behind me, including Ichimoku Secrets. Now, Ichimoku is a magic sauce that I was introduced to by a Japanese trader. It was actually invented by a Japanese investor. And having lived in Japan for 7 years, and while I do speak Japanese, Nihongo pera pera desu, I was able to really dig into Ichimoku. There are some translations about Ichimoku in English, but it really doesn't cover everything that there is about Ichimoku. So I really dove into Ichimoku a number of years ago. And after that, I started applying it across the board to all the assets that I was trading and investing in all different time frames. And I found out that yes, you can in fact apply Ichimoku to different assets across different time frames, but there is a catch. And I have been explaining the Ichimoku secrets in my Ichimoku Secrets course and in my Make Your Money Work for You Power course. Now with these new YouTube series, I've been trying to demystify that across different assets and across different time frames as well. So let's go and take a look at Bitcoin. Mind you that while I use Ichimoku for technical analysis, basically it simplifies my technical analysis process and it magically shows me everything that I want in one glance. But I also do the Invest Diva Diamond analysis, which is the IDDA, which basically I look at any asset that I'm trying to invest in or trade from different points as well, which is fundamentals and market sentiment. And then I put it to my risk tolerance to see if this really makes sense for me before I go ahead and hit that buy or sell button. But today I'm not gonna get that deep. The deeper level of the IDDA is kept for our premium investing group or the PIG members. I'm actually going live again Tuesday at 10 a.m. Every Tuesday I go live in the PIG and I share all my strategies across the assets using the IDDA and Ichimoku. But today I'm going to look specifically at Ichimoku and see where can we buy Bitcoin if we are into Bitcoin, of course. So let's go. So here I have Bitcoin price on the daily chart. Now, as I said before, you can use Ichimoku across different time frames, but with Bitcoin, it's been a little bit more complicated. And in fact, I have stopped trading cryptocurrencies on a shorter time frame, and I've basically turned into a holder or hodler, however you want to pronounce that. So what I've actively been looking for is better buying opportunities, because Bitcoin price has shot up after it kind of bottomed out at around 3,000 back in, it bottomed out in February and then it went all the way up to $14,000 again, and now we're going back again. So the question is, will this go back down to 3,000 level or even lower, or this is it? The $7,000 support level over here is it when it comes to Bitcoin versus the US dollar. So when I look at the Bitcoin versus US dollar daily chart, it did break below the Ichimoku cloud in November 19th. That was, for me, was like, okay, so I think that it is going to go to the next Fibonacci retracement levels. Namely, so we have the real Fibonacci retracement levels actually are, so I've created the Fibonacci from this bottom to this high, right around 13,775. And the levels are, here we have it, 7,362. And actually the next level is here. This is the 78% of natural retracement level is actually below 6,000. So if you really wanted to just completely follow Fibonacci, and considering the fact that the pair has broken below the Ichimoku cloud, this would be the number that the pair could go move towards to. But I wanted to further analyze the pair and not just like rely on the daily chart, because the best thing that happens with the Ichimoku is if across the different time frames, we have the similar kind of signal. Now, this is what we have. Oh, these are my notes for our premium investing groups. So when you look at the monthly chart of Bitcoin, this is what we see. You see what the difference is? The pair is actually still above the Ichimoku cloud, while the future cloud, look, was bearish, is now turning slightly bullish. This is still the Ichimoku cloud right over here. And here, this is also the Ichimoku cloud, and it has been acting as a supporting zone. The pair has still not broken below this tiny little thin Ichimoku cloud over here. So I still don't have further indication that it could in fact go below to 5,000 because the monthly chart, we still don't have a confirmation. December just started while the pair is still going, you know, south. It still hasn't confirmed. Actually, a confirmation, even if it just go all the way down here, because the month of December didn't start below the Ichimoku cloud, we don't have a bearish Ichimoku cloud confirmation on the monthly chart yet. So what I mean by that is that this 61% Fibonacci retracement level could be it. This could be the support level, or the 7,000 level, basically. This is the zone, right? Could be the support zone. And now let's zoom in and go to a short time frame, 4 hour. So in the 4 hour chart, the cloud is actually flat, right? So we've had some activity over here. The future cloud is actually bullish, and the pair has been inside the cloud. So now this is a sign of a consolidation. So together, we actually have a bunch of mixed signals when it comes to Ichimoku cloud and Bitcoin. So what I would do is, so if you're a hardcore Bitcoin fan, I'm not telling you that Bitcoin is right for you. I'm just doing technical analysis here. I'm not doing any sort of fundamental analysis, and I'm not really telling you whether or not you should be buying Bitcoin. Personally, I'm a believer in Bitcoin. I think Bitcoin has a very strong future. So for me, what has made sense is to buy my way down. So I bought I had a buy limit order at 7,000. I also have a buy limit order, actually a little bit higher, because I didn't want to miss out waiting for it to go below, because the 6,000 level is very, very strong. It has acted as a support level for so many times in the past. As you can see here, this used to be a support level. Look how many times 6,200 was a support level, a gazillion times back in November 2017, February 2018, and then multiple times in 2018, it was acting as a key support level. So there's a very good chance that we actually could see Bitcoin reaching 6,200. And even though the Fibonacci retracement level is actually at 5,600, I didn't want to miss out. So I have set a buy limit order at around 6,200, 6,300. I actually bought it even higher because I really didn't want to miss out, right? But if it does reach 6,200, then I'm planning, again, based on my risk tolerance, which is very personal and may not be the right decision for you. You should definitely know your risk tolerance, at least at the minimum, bare minimum, if you're thinking of getting into any kind of asset, including crypto or stocks or forex or what have you. Then if it makes sense to you, you might even want to set up a buy limit order lower. Heck, I actually have a buy limit order at 1996. So this was my call back in the day when Bitcoin was at 3,000. I actually thought Bitcoin could go to this very old support level of below 2,000 before going back up, but I was wrong. The pair actually bottomed out at 3,000. So now will Bitcoin go back to 2,000 before shooting back up? I don't know. Nobody can tell. But because I didn't want to risk missing out, I have set a buy limit order at this price as well. Again, to me, the future of these are, again, so with the Bitcoin time frame, this is still a shorter time frame. Like, even if it takes a year for Bitcoin to go to 2,000, Bitcoin still has 5 years to prove us right and go all the way back up above and beyond 20,000. So this is ultra long-term investment. And I'm only taking this risk because To me, Bitcoin represents something that I truly believe in. So you should also, if you want to get into Bitcoin, if you want to add cryptocurrencies in your portfolio, you should first learn about it, understand what cryptocurrency stands for, understand blockchain technology. And that's what I'm aiming to do with this YouTube channel. And that's the reason why I actually wrote my Cryptocurrency Investing for Dummies book, which is not a crypto book, really. It's a risk management book. It's about diversification. It talks about what crypto is, and it leaves you the decision whether or not you should add cryptocurrency to your portfolio. And you guys, tomorrow, please tune in. I have a very, 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 very special guest. Do you guys watch The Bachelor? I don't know. Many of you probably don't watch The Bachelor. I'm like guilty as charged. I'm a top Bachelor Nation fan. So one of the Bachelor contestants who's been on Bachelor for many years, and he's been on The Bachelor 5 times, which is like the record breaking amount for any other member, Chris Bukowski. I think that's how you pronounce his name, is going to be my guest on Diva on the Block today. So I'm super excited. He actually happened to be into crypto and he's heavily invested. So I'm going to take his opinion and see what he thinks about the cryptocurrency investing and the cryptocurrency world in general. So that should be fun. Definitely make sure you tune in tomorrow. And in the meantime, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you like it. If you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and click on that subscribe button, turn on that bell button so that you don't miss out when I publish my new videos. I've been publishing videos every single day, new content about investing, money mindset, stocks, analysis, like literally everything that you need in order to start, manage, and grow your family's investment portfolio. I'm going to cover in this new YouTube channel. So don't forget to subscribe. And in the meantime, don't forget to make your money work for you. And I'll see you in the next video.